simple and clean is the way that you're making me feel tonight. It's hard to let
Let's go.
They did it. They actually did it. I can't believe it. You know, usually I take a second and use these, you know, character reveal videos to crap on people that get upset and salty over a particular character reveal. But this time, man, I really just want to take a second and just give Nintendo a round of applause for being able to work out a partnership with Square Enix and Disney, for being able to include Sora from Kingdom Hearts in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. In my opinion, this seals the deal. This is by far easily the greatest accumulation of video game characters in any single video game in all of video game history. Hands down, it's not even close. There's not even anybody else in the conversation. This is the one. This is the game. This game should go down in all of our histories and just the monumental achievement of what they were able to accomplish with this final DLC character. You know, even I didn't think that they would be able to get Sora, because Disney is so protective of their characters. And even with the inclusion of Sora, we're definitely not seeing any Mickey Mouse, Goofy, or Donald Duck. I mean, we get the Mickey Mouse emblem, but you're definitely not seeing the actual Disney characters. I mean, you're getting the Kingdom Hearts characters, but you're not getting any, you know, classic Disney characters. Well, so that's fine. That's fine with me, man. I think the main character that everybody wanted was Sora. I mean, that shouldn't be any secret to anybody. If you've been following this news for as many years as I have, I think it's been 3.5 years now since I've been talking about this game on this channel. Yeah, even I've been talking about this game since my YouTube channel was in its infancy. How about that, man? And now to get the final DLC reveal is just, it's almost kind of sad in a way. But, you know, we're still going to have more, you know, Smash Brothers content. Of course, they're going to come out with an amiibo and some gameplay. So we're still going to have stuff to talk about in Smash Brothers for the channel for this game. But I don't know, it's just something about a Smash Brothers character revealed. It just reminds me of my childhood. It reminds me of, you know, the reasonings on why I became a gamer in the first place. I've been playing Mario and Zelda games since I was 5 years old. So, you know, obviously this is going to have a specific, you know, grasp on my soul. You know, I've played every Super Smash Brothers since the beginning, since the Nintendo 64. No, it's just something that just will always be special to me. And just the inclusion of characters that they've been able to bring to this game, from Sonic to Solid Snake to Banjo-Kazooie to Cloud to now to Sora, Pac-Man, that are not even Nintendo characters. I mean, it's something else. I just don't understand that people really can still have the audacity to try to hate and throw shade and troll. I mean, dude, there's just no way. You know, I mean, if you can find anywhere in your, you know, psyche to still try to hate on this game, I would go as far as to say, are you even a gamer? No, serious question. Are you even a gamer? Do you play video games? I mean, it was a couple of comments that I saw like, oh, but it's not Master Chief. I'm never playing this game again. You're ridiculous. Well, I mean, that's fine, man. I think people sometimes just have to get on the internet to troll, just to get their opinion out, to make themselves feel important. So I know, like, the proper YouTuber thing to do when, let's talk about his moveset, let's talk about his final smash. I don't care, man. I'm just happy that he's in the game. You know, he's gonna swing the Keyblade around. Kingdom Hearts is an RPG, so obviously he's gonna have some fire attacks, some lightning attacks. I mean, I don't think I've ever played an RPG where the main character didn't have some fire, some ice, and some lightning. You know, so I mean, pretty self-explanatory. His upwards move kind of looks like Link's spin attack. His final smash looks like he shoots out a key kind of dart that opens up a keyhole, and you shoot the opponent into the keyhole. So that's pretty sweet. But other than that, I have no doubt in my mind that the character is going to be super fun to use. You know, the one thing that I did hear Sakurai say that kind of caught my attention, that he is going to be a super light character, the lightest character in the game, even lighter than a Pichu. So that's definitely something to keep in mind. So you better take out your opponent fast if you're Sora. If not, and it sounds like if you're at like 60 or 70%, you're at danger. So that's definitely something to keep in mind. But, you know, other than gameplay aside, you know, the stage looks really cool too. You know, I did find the stage reveal a little bit funny, you know, because they were showing off all of the Kingdom Hearts characters, but again, in the background, but they still weren't able to, you know, put some classic Disney characters in the stage either. So whatever deal Nintendo worked out with Square Enix and Disney, you know, it looks like they were able to work it out specifically with Square Enix, to where they were able to use the Kingdom Hearts original characters, but it looks like Disney was still clearly very tight squeezed on its classic characters. Like, no, you're not using our classic characters or our movie characters for your game. You can have the Square Enix characters, but no, you're not getting the Mickey Mouses or your Goofies or your Donald Ducks. It's just not happening. Which, again, that's completely fine with me. And y'all know me, especially if you follow my channel, this is coming from a major Disney guy. I mean, hell, I go to Walt Disney World 2 to 3 times a year. So, I mean, would it have been cool to see Mario take on Mickey Mouse? Sure, man. Is it a deal breaker? Absolutely not. And it shouldn't be for anybody at all. Is it a deal breaker that Waluigi didn't get into the game? No, stop saying that that's terrible. It's not. Waluigi is represented in the game. He's an assist trophy that is better than nothing. Stop it. The half of the roster is Mario characters. You're being ridiculous. And I'm a huge Sonic the Hedgehog fan. Am I a little bit sad that Tails or Dr. Eggman didn't get into the game? Sure, man. But I'm not going to let that derail my experience of playing one of the literally the greatest party game of all time. There's no way. I'm happy that Sonic even made it into the game in the first place. Sonic makes a good game maybe every 15 years. Sorry, Sonic fans, but it's the truth. No, it's a blessing that he even made it in. But aside from all that, man, I just, if you don't get anything else from this video, you just need to take into account just the accomplishment that Nintendo was able to do for us. They did not have to put this much effort into this game. They did not have to pay these companies probably an insane amount of money for a partnership to use their characters. They didn't have to do that. Know what too? I even went across some of these Super Smash Brothers fan groups on Facebook, and I went and I collected about 20 different posts that, you know, hated on Sora being included in the game. But you know what? I'm not even going to use them. I don't think they deserve to be in this video. You know, I've done that shade before, especially with Bailiff. And you know, like I said, I've done that shade before where I just hated on a bunch of people hating on the character reveal. And it was even some people saying that, like, oh, another anime sword character, you're an idiot. So now what I'm looking forward to, amiibos. Yes, we haven't gotten any news of when the Sora amiibo is going to be announced yet, but definitely excited to be able to get a Sora amiibo added on to the amiibo shelf in my collection. If you follow my channel, you know that I have every current Smash Brothers amiibo on display. Some of them have collected a mountain of dust, but you know, that's okay. We'll grab our duster when the new ones come in, and then we will dust it off and we will display them in an amiibo review when they all come out, man. So, which is coolly ironic too, of how this trailer was too, that had all of them start off in their trophy forms from like Super Smash Brothers Melee. That was really sweet too, man. And speaking of this trailer, oh, just amazing. Even so much that I had to sing the song, man. You know, a little tidbit about me, I used to sing the heck out of Simple and Clean and Sanctuary from Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2. Like, I had that on my MP3 player in high school for basically the entire time I was in high school. Yep, I was one of those kids. You gotta love it, man. You're like, what's a video game if it doesn't have amazing video game music? I'm just saying, you know, the video game music, yeah, it's such an, it should be such an important aspect in all of our gamer lives. It really is. And those two songs had a major impact on me. Major. So just the inclusion of Kingdom Hearts in general, like, I'm so happy for it, man. I'm just, it's just amazing. Like, I cannot get over the scope of how amazing this is for just video games in general. Like, I'm just in awe. If you can't tell, I'm just in absolute awe, man. I'm so satisfied, and I'm gonna end it there. So I want to know how y'all feel, man. Post in the comments below, positive or negative. You know, if you had a positive outlook on Sora, then tell me your love for it. Tell me your first Kingdom Hearts moment. Tell me your first Smash Brothers moment. I want to know. If you had a negative, if you think I'm stupid, if you think Smash Brothers is stupid, if you think Kingdom Hearts is stupid, post that in the comments too. I'll probably make fun of you. You know, no hard feelings. It's not personal, but I'm just telling the truth. It is what it is. But, you know, with that, man, do me a favor and hit that like button. You can also hit that notification bell icon. We talk about Smash Brothers all the time, or at least when some super news for it comes out. You can follow me at youtube.com/martinjack79. I'm also on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And as always, I will see you guys on the next one. I'll catch you guys later. Bye.